Hello again, everyone. Welcome back to the channel. My name is Prestige, and this video today was sponsored by the Call of Duty League. Major 2 is finally here, and it begins today, March 31st, and it goes until April 3rd, Championship Sunday. Just as a quick refresher from what happened in Major 1, Optic Texas was really able to show Atlanta FaZe who was boss with a 5-2 victory in the championship finals. Optic Dashy was even named MVP of the LAN event through Major 1. So I know for sure, especially through the qualifiers, they have been fired up and they are ready for Major 2, and I'm thinking they're going to come out swinging just like they did before. And don't forget, when you tune into Major 2 with the link in the description below, you can earn viewership rewards as long as your Activision account and your YouTube account are linked. This includes exclusive calling cards, emblems, and even a weapon blueprint available for tuning in on Championship Sunday. And after Major 2 comes to a close, there's a brand new Call of Duty League Resurgence Rebirth Island event taking place. This event is specifically for players located and physically in North America. Open signups are live right now, and they're going to be available until April 7th, so visit that link in the description below and prepare yourself for some of the sweatiest Call of Duty you have ever experienced in your life. There is $100,000 at stake here, and I know that there's a lot of people who are going to be going after it. It's open signups. Link in the description below. If you think you got what it takes, then sign up today. Big thank you once again to the CDL for sponsoring today's video. Major 2 is kicking off very soon, so visit that link down below. You know, it's been a while since we've sat down and talked about Prestige keys, but I figured today would be a good time more than ever because Treyarch just updated the system. So no matter where you're playing, you will be earning Prestige keys, which was initially what was supposed to happen. Unfortunately, there were some issues that were causing some problems, but the good news is, no matter where you've been playing, whether it's Modern Warfare, Warzone, or even Vanguard, every 50 levels, you've been earning a key. And even though that hasn't properly been reflected in Black Ops Cold War, with the most recent update yesterday, all of those levels that you've gained through Season 1 of Vanguard and beyond have now been retroactively added to your account. So if you've been ranking up like crazy, no matter where you've been playing, you have a huge stash of Prestige keys ready to be used on, well, pretty much anything you want in the Prestige shop. And that started to make me think a little bit more about what this possibly could have been, and not only that, where this shop could have gone if they decided to end up keeping it in the game. Now, this is a topic that we talked about pretty extensively when Black Ops Cold War was first introduced, and we all finally started to see the inner workings of what the Prestige shop had. Now, over time, it got updated to add more emblems, more extensive emblems across multiple titles, more titles were added into the fray, and we also even got a blueprint shop, but this all came towards the very end of the game's life. And it really does create an entirely new conversation, which I've been meaning to have because we're drawing ever so close to the next Call of Duty title, which we all assume is going to be called Modern Warfare 2. I think it's all but confirmed at this point. What's the Prestige mode going to look like? Now that we know that Call of Duty is heading into a new generation called COD 2.0, I really do think it's entirely possible to see the return of a classic Prestige system or something that resembles a classic Prestige system. I've personally always been under the impression that when we have access to a Prestige system and actually needing to restart from scratch, minus a couple of things that we end up getting to keep when we use a Prestige token or something along the likes of that, it adds a little bit more balance and a little more variety to the multiplayer that we engage in. And what I mean by that is we don't always see the same weapon over and over and over again unless someone takes that particular weapon with their Prestige key. There's just so much in the game normally that one Prestige key is usually utilized for, say, a perk, or maybe that one weapon that you're trying to work on and get gold camo for, or maybe you'd rather use that one Prestige token for, I don't know, a launcher because you want to be a team player, or that token can be used for a specific streak. You guys get where I'm going with this at this point. There's always so much variety, and as we see everyone in the lobby switching their Prestige level, starting from scratch, going from the ground floor again, there's always so much variety that we encounter, and that's what I've always really liked about the Prestige system. And plus, it always does feel nice to reach top rank and know that you've had to essentially restart from scratch every single time, and that always is nice to, you know, reveal a new emblem and, you're not just going up 50 levels and you're not just really dealing with levels at that point. You're dealing with so many other moving parts that you have to strategize how you're going to handle your next prestige, what that token is going to pick up, which weapon is bound to give you the most XP because you've worked far enough to unlock the camo patterns, or which one's going to give you the diamond camos, what challenges in your barracks menu are close to being completed, do you need to unlock a perk? This is why I truly feel with Infinity Ward ushering a new era of Call of Duty titled COD 2.0, there could be a return of the classic prestige mode because of everything we just got done talking about. Now, seasonal battle passes and things of that nature, I'm sure, are still going to exist, but a classic prestige system could coexist. But this is what I'm personally hoping for when it comes to Modern Warfare 2 in 2022. I would love to see a classic prestige system, 10 to 15 prestiges, have us go through and reset and lose all of our progress, give us a prestige token like we've seen in the past, let us unlock one thing per prestige level. Then once you get to 15th prestige, everything at that point is unlocked. You don't have to worry about prestige tokens anymore, and you can continue grinding by ranking up. Now, normally, this is where the game would let you go to level 1000, but in the case of having seasons, I really do feel like this is a good opportunity for them to have a never-ending level cap. And this is also a great opportunity to reintroduce the prestige key system. Since you're not technically able to prestige anymore, you're just going through the ranks at that point, you could allow people every 50 levels to earn a prestige key to go back and unlock the things that we saw in Black Ops Cold War, whether that be calling cards, legacy prestige emblems, or even weapon blueprints, because we know they're not going anywhere. But why stop there? Add a ton of cosmetics that you can earn in this. Calling cards, emblems, weapon blueprints, character outfits, camouflage patterns. I mean, hell, if we really wanted to get crazy, they could even add full-on operators in here in the form of legacy characters. And I really do think this would be an incredible opportunity to cross-pollinate with Warzone 2.0, giving people to show off their unique operators and characters that they've unlocked via the Prestige Shop in Modern Warfare 2. There's just so much that they can do to this, and the best part is it would kill two birds with one stone. The first thing would be fixing the prestige situation, because people have been asking for classic prestige back for a very long time. So that would be there alongside seasonal prestiging. The second thing it would do is add a bunch of in-game content that you can grind for, that you can play for, instead of always needing to whip out your wallet and spend some money in the shop. This would allow players to spend their time ranking up, gathering the keys that they want to get that special operator, to get that special camouflage pattern, to unlock that amazing looking Mastercraft blueprint with unique animations, and you know, the list can go on and on and on. So here's the easiest way to look at what I'm currently trying to propose. If you are a player out there who does not like the classic prestige mode, you don't have to be part of it. You can go up to level 55, get all of your military ranks done, unlock every single weapon in the game, and still have your seasonal ranking like you would before. So it can go past 55 all the way up to whatever level you want, because there would be unlimited leveling at that point. Those keys that you're unlocking can still be used for stuff in the shop. However, if you want to get access to even more, you're going to have to go to Prestige 2. And if you want to unlock even more after that, you're going to have to go to Prestige 3. And if you wanted to get everything available in the shop, you would have to go all the way up to Prestige Master after 10th Prestige. And then from there, you can continue ranking and ranking and ranking, earning a ton of Prestige keys and unlocking a bunch of cosmetics. That's what I'm trying to propose. So everybody could choose what they want to do. You could choose to go ahead and Prestige classically like you normally would, lose everything and restart from scratch, or keep everything that you want and still participate in seasonal ranking and still participate in earning prestige keys and having access to some of the items in the prestige shop. But going all the way would then unlock everything for you. I honestly think that would be an amazing system. I don't know what they're planning. I have no clue at this point. But that's the thing that makes the most sense to me. It's the best of both worlds. It gives pretty much everybody every possibility to play. It also tackles the problem of not having that many cosmetic items to unlock by playing the game. And I think it would create a better ecosystem for our community, period. And that's what I got to say about the situation. I love the Prestige shop. I'd love to see it return. I'd love to see more of it in the future. And I'd like to see it evolve in some way more to a classical form, but also moving forward in the future, allowing even more ways to rank up. And in some cases, unlimited rank up. Could you imagine like the race to Prestige? And there's just like two or three teams fighting to try to see who can be the highest rank in the game. We'd have people at like rank 50,000 in the first couple of months. It would be ridiculous. But anyway, that is everything I wanted to talk about here in this video today. Once again, big thank you to the CDL for sponsoring this video. And if y'all enjoyed my ramblings, please feel free to leave a like on this video, subscribe for more awesome content coming each and every day. And don't forget to ring the bell icon. Join that notification squad. And I'll catch you all on the next video. Peace.